Hey, what's up, Card Nation? Welcome to Season 2, Episode 21 of the Off the Walls podcast, presented by the State of Louisville and brought to you by the Granville Pub at 1601 South 3rd Street. I'm your host, Brian Trent, and today I will be joined by reporter from WHAS11 and the host of The Wrap, Tyler Greever. Tyler, thanks for coming back on Off the Walls.
Yeah, it's good to be back, man. It's been a while and a lot to talk about.
Yeah, I kind of saved you till the end where we can just throw a whole bow on this whole regular season and a ACC tournament.
Yeah.
So coming off a Final Four, coming into this season, what were your expectations for the Louisville women's basketball team this year?
I think like anybody else, I had pretty high expectations. You know, you saw what they were bringing back from last season, and then you saw the additions of Morgan Jones and Josie Williams and CC Carr, and you're like, wow, they have depth. They have pretty much anything they need, I think, seeing coming into this season. And then we saw the start of the year where, okay, the pieces haven't fully clicked yet. You know, I think that's something that maybe, you know, we as reporters and even fans or anybody took for granted last year was how quickly that Louisville team that made a Final Four run gelled and everybody understood exactly what their roles were. Even two brand new players from the transfer portal and Emily Anxler and Chelsea Hall knew exactly what they needed to do to get that team going. I mean, Kiana was a transfer as well, but she had been in the program a little bit. She wasn't brand new to it. So I think that's something that everybody's learned this year is that it's not going to be automatic. We all know from sports that you sometimes the reality doesn't quite meet the expectations. This is still a good team. It just did not, you know, live up to the lofty preseason top 10, one or two seed that Louisville fans have gotten used to seeing.
Do you think we kind of put unfair expectations on Jeff Walz after what he did with Emily Anxler and Chelsea Hall last year, that he was going to do the same thing with CC and Morgan Jones and Josie Williams?
I wouldn't use the word unfair because Jeff is one of the best coaches in the country. He has the track record to back it up. He has the development record to back it up, whether it's players who have gone on to the WNBA or players who came into Louisville and got better every single year and saw their role change every single year. So I think it's maybe just a bit of a reality check more than anything is that, you know, just because a player is productive somewhere else doesn't mean they're going to come into a new situation with new expectations and a new coaching staff and immediately get it. You know, this is not a video game. It's not like, you know, it's not like you're playing franchise mode in Madden and you just grab the player who's a 90 something overall and put them on your roster and your team's amazing, right? That these are actual human beings and that the chemistry and everything has to work out. And I think it took Louisville a good bit of time this season to figure that out. And I still don't think they have it fully figured out. And if they do get that last bit of click, I think they can make a pretty nice push in the NCAA tournament.
Well, we start the season off okay, get to the Bahamas, lose to Gonzaga, lose to South Dakota State, who's usually a pretty good team, usually ranked in the top 25, beat Texas. After that, did you say it's the Bahamas, they had to travel a long way, they'll figure it out when they get home, or was it more of a, well, this could be alarming?
I think it was too early in the season to say alarming. I think this program has gotten so used to, frankly, just not losing much during the regular season that obviously it's something that catches your eye. I will say I thought their non-conference schedule was pretty challenging this year. Even the so-called, you know, mid-major opponents, a lot of them were NCAA tournament teams or are going to be NCAA tournament teams again. So I always thought Jeff had a good point with that. But having said that, even in other years where Louisville has played NCAA tournament level mid-majors, they won a lot of those games well, A, they just won, and B, you could probably go back to them and say, wow, they won that pretty handily. So I think it was like the first sign of like, all right, maybe not everything is quite where it needs to be yet. Like there's an adjustment that's still got to be made, and it's probably going to take a little bit.
Well, I'll admit I was one that said that this wasn't the non-conference schedule that Jeff Walz usually schedules. Do you think it's everyone thought the teams were easier? It's just there wasn't the name value of UConn and Michigan and the teams he usually gets to schedule?
There probably just wasn't the name value. I mean, I think you're probably relying on people to be better consumers of women's basketball, to be able to recognize the value of going to Middle and to playing Belmont. I mean, even Gonzaga, you know, people are familiar with Gonzaga from Louisville playing them last year in the NCAA tournament, but most basketball fans obviously identify Gonzaga with the men's program and not the women's program, even though they have built a good women's program. So I think it's more of that. It would probably be more of a name value thing, in my opinion.
Well, as we're going through the non-conference schedule, you know, we were in them all, could have won most of them until we get to Middle Tennessee State. And that's the one game you can say that, I mean, Louisville got their ass kicked.
Yeah, no, it was I think that was the, you used the word alarming. I think that was probably as close as you could come to saying, wow, what is going on here? Like a loss and getting routed are two different things. And they got routed in that game. And then, of course, you know, that was right around when we all learned that Peyton Verhulst was transferring as well, which I think caught everybody a little by surprise, considering how successful she was as a freshman and how highly touted of a recruit she was. So all those factors combining, I think that might have been a point where a lot of fans were like, whoa, like what's happening here?
Well, as Morgan Jones comes in, she's a two-time first-team All-ACC, All-ACC defender. What do you think has been the thing that has held her back this season, that she hasn't been able to perform on the level she did before she got here?
I think it's a great question. I wish I had like a fully definitive answer on it. I wish I would, you know, was in practice every day and could see whatever, you know, disconnect there is between what Jeff expects and what Morgan has given him this year. One thing that I guess I can speculate on for a sec is that, look, when Morgan was at Florida State, she was the top dog. She was the top option.
She was their Haley Van Lith.
Yeah, I mean, she was the number one go-to player. And I think she had to know coming here that that wasn't going to be the case, that she could still be a highly productive player, but you're also joining some pretty solid pieces already. I always thought when she came to Louisville that she would be the second scoring option behind Haley. Like Haley would probably lead the team in points, which she did, and then Morgan would probably be right behind her in that. And you caught a glimpse of that when she went back to Florida State earlier this year and had a great game, dropped a lot of points, and was probably her, you know, one of her better performances of the season. But I think what has happened is there hasn't been like a needed adjustment of, just because you're not the top dog or you're not scoring as much as you want, you have so many other things to your game that can help this team. Like, I think when she's fully turned up defensively, she is a monster out there. She's athletic, she's long. You know, I remember Jeff talking about her defensive prowess multiple times coming into the season and how impressed he was. And that's really what Emily did. Like, I don't want to get into this whole like direct comparison between Emily and Morgan. They're different players. Like, they're different players. I think Emily had a natural instinct on the defensive end of the floor that is very, very hard to find. Like, you are not just going to go out and replace that. However, I do think Morgan could fill some of that role a little bit more, could have filled some of that role a little bit more. And of course, you know, the tournament, I think, is a huge spot. It's pretty much like a gut check of look, I think if Louisville really, really wants to make a deep run, they have to get more out of her. They have to figure that out. And if that means Jeff leaves her in for longer stretches and lives with some of the mistakes that maybe she makes because she's that talented of a player, then that's something he might have to come to grips with. That doesn't equate to her starting, but she has not really played a whole lot of minutes since the end of the season and even in the ACC tournament.
Well, Joe, everybody critiques Jeff Walz for not recruiting bigs. So he goes out and gets Josie Williams. She was a career, I think it was like 24 and 12, 24 and 15, something like that at Utah Valley State. I think we all had high hopes of what she was going to bring to the team. I mean, is it just she hasn't related to the speed of a Power 5 conference schedule?
Maybe so, yeah. But, I'll be honest. I think even when Louisville brought her in, I didn't view Josie as like, okay, that's a starter. You know, that's Olivia and Liz are both good players. Like, especially, I think when Olivia is hitting on all fronts, like, she can really help take this team to another notch. And she kind of looks like she's finding that right now. I really like what she showed in Greensboro. She was aggressive offensively. She's always pretty solid defensively. She's very strong, very agile for her size. So I think Josie, out of the three between her, CeCe, and Morgan, was the one that I probably didn't have as high expectations for. Not dissing her as a player. I just thought Louisville already had two experienced bigs who have been under Jeff for years. And then you add in the fact you had another big come in Isla Harris as a freshman, who demonstrated very quickly that she wasn't a normal freshman and that she needs to play. Like, and she brings things that Louisville needed. So I think, you know, Josie obviously probably could have done some things better. Maybe Jeff could have figured out a way to work her more in, or maybe figures out a way to work her more in. I actually think she's got a pretty nice jump shot from mid-range and from the three-point line to help, like, spread the defense out a little bit. But I think it's a byproduct of, like, is she going to take away minutes from Nyla, Olivia, or Liz? And I don't think so.
Well, we bring CeCe in from Syracuse, and she shot the lights out this season.
Yeah, she's been great.
But she'll shoot good one game, and then the next game, she'll shoot the ball like seven times. Is there something they need to do to run more sets for her to get Haley better shots? Because, she's been the predominant three-point shooter on the team.
Right. I think there probably could be a better focal point of trying to get CeCe some better scoring opportunities or more shots, or a wider shot selection, if you will, as opposed to, I think the scoring thing has turned into Haley's your top option and CeCe's the second best scorer on the team. She is the best shooter, like, period, like, just knockdown shooter. She's that. But I think what we learned with CeCe was Louisville's best option this season was not her running point guard. It was Mikasa running point guard. And it took a while to figure that out, but it's because CeCe's best talents as a player have shown to be as a scorer, as opposed to being a distributor, which is fine. That's just, again, I think we all fell into a comparison game of, like, all right, Morgan equates to Emily and CeCe equates to Chelsea Hall. And it's like, no, that's not how it worked. Like, they're different players. They have different strengths. But I think CeCe has really come on. Well, first of all, she's produced all year as a shooter. But the difference between her now and I think the beginning of the season is her defensive intensity right now is awesome. Like, in the ACC tournament, I thought she cranked it up. I thought she was putting on constant pressure, especially when you watch the Notre Dame game and see what she did with Sonia Citron. Well, she did a great job. And then she dropped 27 against Virginia Tech. So getting her back in the starting lineup, I think, was something Jeff had to do, because she's too good of a scoring option. And if she's giving you that much effort on defense now, she's earned her way back into that lineup.
Is Nyla Harris the freshman, the player on the team that you've been most impressed with this season, or who have you been most impressed with this season?
Yeah, I think it's got to be Nyla, just because, she was a highly rated recruit. Like, she wasn't coming in here and people didn't have expectations for. So she's like the breakout player for me in that I don't think anybody pegged her to be a starter at some point. For a majority of the season, she finished well around the rim. She's kind of struggled with that lately. So it'd be huge for Louisville if she could kind of shake that bug and get back to being a little bit more reliable around the rim. But she is tenacious defensively. Her effort is, as Jeff has said a million times, is great. And something you can't, like, if somebody already has that, you don't even have to coach that up. And that's huge. She has, like, I think she can be a star. I mean, if she really develops her jump shot a little bit more to hit consistently from mid-range and the free throw line, which she showed some growth in this year, that's the next step for her. She's the most, you know, she's the breakout player for me. I guess if I was going to give like an MVP, I don't know if you're going to build to this question, but like, it's got to be Mikasa. Like, who I think she has done a phenomenal job of wearing whatever hat this team needed her to wear. Like, that's her MO. She's a leader. She's the best defender. She's the best passer. She's the highest IQ player, the smartest player. So her transition into becoming basically the de facto point guard, I don't think a lot of players could just do that. And she did it seamlessly. And I, you know, that move alone made this team better. So I would say, yeah, Nyla is the breakout one. But if you're going to give like an MVP for this team, I think Mikasa has been that.
Well, last season, Jeff Walz started a starting lineup against Arizona. And that starting lineup started until we lost to South Carolina in the Final Four. Right. He tried that at the beginning of this season, but then he's had like 17 other starting lineups. I mean, is that one of the problems? Just he could never find the right starting lineup and the right rotation of when to sub in and out for the players to really get them to click?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it's a unique situation, to be honest. Like, I think coaches tinker with their lineups throughout the year, depending on matchups, tendencies, who's hot, who's not. Louisville was very fortunate last season to have a steady five who understood their roles to start a game. And I think you got to keep in mind as well that, like, yeah, was Narika starting for a stretch? Yes, she was. But she was coming out a couple minutes into the game in some of those cases. So to either put, you know, whoever in, like, whatever the game was calling for, maybe CeCe gets in earlier, maybe Liz gets some run, maybe Morgan gets in there for a few minutes. It just depended. So sometimes you're a starter in title, but you don't always have the starter's minutes to go by. And I think Jeff did all he could pretty much this season to give everybody a lot of run to see what he could expect night in and night out. And that was a struggle for him, I think, with that he was at a point before this lineup change where he didn't know what he was going to get from various players. So eventually he was like, all right, I think these are the five I can trust the most right now. I know they're at least going to give a lot of defensive effort and we'll figure it out from there. And that was the move he had to make to kind of, for lack of a better word, spark this team or at least send a message of like, look, we're going to get this straightened out if we're going to win some games this year.
And I know he's found five that he trusts, but with the size disadvantage of those five,
yeah.
I mean, can they take us through the NCAA tournament when you match up to a South Carolina or a Connecticut or a Stanford or?
Yeah, it's a tough question to answer. I mean, I think the way they played in Greensboro, first, I thought they had a great showing. Obviously, you know, they dominated Wake Forest. They dominated Notre Dame. Yeah, I mean, Olivia Miles didn't play, but Notre Dame's still a top 10 team in the country with plenty of other talent. And it was a beatdown, total beatdown, and a bit of a revenge game as well. You watch the Tech game, and, like, I think you could tell that they were maybe a little gassed in that first half. But also, Virginia Tech's really damn good offensively. I mean, they have multiple weapons across the floor. And I thought there were a few shots they hit where I was like, look, you can guard that however you want, but that's just a really good player hitting a really tough shot. And there were some chances, I think, for Louisville to maybe seize some momentum when they got back in the game in the second half. But then they would come with one of those turnovers that happens. And that's been a huge problem this year, with just some badly timed turnovers or fouls or what have you. But to answer your question, I mean, you know, I think you have to worry about it a little bit. Going up against if you run into some of the more elite teams in the country. But Louisville's at its best when it's pressuring the hell out of you and forcing turnovers and getting steals and going in transition. So if you need to impose your style on whoever you're going to play. And then, yeah, if the size is an issue, that's when you get Liz and Olivia out there on the floor at the same time or try to mix it up a little bit. But, you know, their best brand of basketball is causing chaos. So whatever they can do to do that in the NCAA tournament, they have to try and do that.
After how the non-conference schedule went, did the conference schedule kind of go the way you thought it would? We'd lose 4 or 5 games in conference, probably be a 4 or 5 seed. Or do you think we would turn around and show better during the conference schedule?
I thought that they played pretty well in conference play. Obviously, it didn't add up to an ACC championship, but this was a really good year for the ACC. I think it's very deep. Having said that, I don't think I expected a loss to Wake Forest. That probably should not have happened. And I think that was a breaking point for Jeff, too, in terms of changing the lineup. But the way I always take it as anything else, how did you perform against the elite teams in the conference? And so when they played Notre Dame twice, you had 2 games that could have gone either way. You know, whether you thought Olivia Miles traveled at the end before she hit her last second
100%.
Shot, like whatever you think about it, either way, you know, there's other plays that determine a game too, and Louisville could have made them and won the game. If they make a few more layups, they win the game. You could say the same thing about going to Virginia Tech. That was a hell of a game in Blacksburg, and it comes down to a last second shot not going in from Haley. You know, Duke was a tight game in Durham. And then even NC State, who's not, I think NC State's like a little comparable to Louisville this year in that they're not the power that they usually are of recent years. But that game was like Louisville controlled that game for 3 quarters and just went literally as cold as you possibly could in the fourth. So I look at how they've played against some elite competition. Hell, even go back out of conference for a sec. Sorry, I know you asked about conference, but go back to the Ohio State game in the UM Center. I mean, they were really looking good in that game, and then they started turning the ball over like crazy. So against elite competition, I think they've shown themselves well this year, even beating Texas to go back to out of conference. That was a big win. So, I mean, I think I would have expected maybe a little bit closer to an ACC regular season title, but all in all, they probably could have been in that conversation if like a couple baskets go a different way at the end of games.
Have you ever seen a team miss as many layups as Louisville's missed this season?
I don't know. I mean, I guess, I don't know. I've covered sports for a while. So like, I'm just kind of getting used to some of this stuff. I don't know. You know, I think it's definitely something that if it'd be amazing what their record probably is if you finish around the basket a little bit better. I actually think that's something Olivia did do a better job of in Greensboro. Overall, I love when she plays aggressive offensively because I think her quickness is an advantage that she can use even over bigs that have a little bit of height on her. You know, she's so strong and so quick on her feet that I think she can get a step on them to go to the rack and but then you got to finish. And I thought she did a good job of that in Greensboro. Again, that's one of the things Jeff loves about Nyla. She's just a little off right now. She's got to find that again if they're going to, you know, make some noise in the tournament. But I think the ones that are probably the most frustrating is when you can't finish in transition. You know, when you try to create as many turnovers as Louisville does, the points off turnovers stat is huge. So if you can, you know, those quick change turnovers, like where you get right back down the floor, yeah, those need to be layups and ones, like, they got to be finished. Same thing with like an offensive rebound right at the cup. Like, again, putbacks and ones, like you got to put those away.
Well, so we're probably going to be a 5 or 6 seed and not host for the first time in, gosh, I don't know, probably like 5 or 6 years at least. I mean, the most loss we've had since like 2016-17 season. What is one main thing Louisville needs to do going to the NCAA tournament to make another deep run?
Well, I mean, they're going to have to defend like hell. I mean, there's no getting around it. Like, you saw them when they've been at their best this season is when they force turnovers, when they cause pressure, when they make you second guess everything. That's when they're at their best. So the defense has got to lead the way. I think that has been well demonstrated at this point this season. Other keys, like they're going to need, I think, a more efficient Haley. Like Haley can score with the best of them, but I think she has games where she feels like she has to shoot 21 times, whatever. And there probably could be some better shot selection there. But that also requires other players stepping up and being aggressive to score. And that's where CeCe comes in. Like they need her hitting shots from the outside. Down low, when Olivia and Nyla and Liz get their opportunities, like, yeah, you got to finish with contact, get and ones, rebound the ball. And the X factor in all of it, well, actually, before I even get to another player, don't turn the ball over. The turnovers were a huge problem, I think, this season. And I actually think Louisville has gotten better at it, mainly because Mikasa Robinson took over the point guard position and she instills a lot of intelligence and just calmness and experience running the show. But the X factor is Morgan. There's no getting around it. Like if they can even get, like, I don't even want to put a percentage on it, but like if they can get any production close to what she was doing at Florida State consistently, then it changes a lot for them. She's that talented of a player, and I'm not trying to be hard on her at all. You're just calling it how it is. Like the production has not been what people thought it would be, but that doesn't mean that, you know, this is the time of year where you can leave a lasting memory impression on a whole fan base if you turn it up. And I don't think it's from a lack of want or effort or anything like that. Her and Jeff probably just have to bluntly discuss, like, look, this is what we need this time of year. Like, do you think you can meet this? And if she does, then I think it really, really helps them out.
Going to the tournament, I know Haley has that killer in her, that Mamba mentality. But do you worry about the amount of minutes she's played this season?
I think you have to worry about anybody who plays that many minutes, right? Like, you look at the men's side of things and people want to criticize L. Ellis at times. And I'm like, well, L's playing like 36 minutes a game. And he's the best scorer. He's the best distributor. He's probably not going to be a great defender if he's got to do all of that. I'm sorry. It's just not going to work. And I feel the same way with Haley at times in that, yeah, she's got to shoot a lot because at times there's not enough people who want to shoot the ball. Now, having said that, I do think she can be a little bit better of a distributor and needs to turn down a few more, like, those contested mid-range, or like when she's driving into a defender and there's hard contact and she's forcing it up. There's some of those that got to be cut out, and where she could probably find a better option. She's a better rebounder than she gives credit for. I actually think she attacks the glass for a guard very well. And she's gotten better as a defender. She's got a decent amount of steals. She's not, you know, locked down like Mikasa is by any means, but I think she's gotten better. Still, if there's a way to conserve her a little bit in those early, in that first game, you probably want to try and do that if you're Jeff. Like I'm saying, if they can get up by a comfortable amount, I wouldn't be surprised if he tried to give her a little bit of extra rest. So, yeah, I mean, I think any time a player is playing the amount of minutes she does, it has to be in the back of your head. You have to be aware of it. But there's no doubt with the way she produced in the tournament last year, with what she has shown in a lot of big games, yeah, the expectations are going to be high for her and the spotlight's going to be on her.
Before the season and right now, how has your Louisville basketball season's Florida finish and ceiling to finish changed? Like, how has it changed? What you thought their floor was going to be and what their ceiling was going to be for the season?
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Ceiling-wise, I thought they could get to another Final Four when the year started. I think they can do that now, but that is banking on them playing, like, consistently putting together their best basketball. And I don't think you can say you are fully confident in them doing that yet, because they haven't quite been able to do that all year. Inconsistency within just the course of one game has been a problem. Like, one half looks completely different from the other, or one quarter looks completely different from the other. So the floor for me coming into the season was probably like, all right, Sweet 16, Elite Eight, something like that. But now your floor could be getting bounced in that first or second round, because let's say, you know, the inconsistent Louisville shows up, the bad side of it, they're turning the ball over, the defense is not as intense as we saw in Greensboro. Excuse me, Haley and CeCe are not hitting enough shots, and you're missing layups around the rim. Like, you can get bounced that way. And you know as well as I do, the tournament's as much about your draw and the matchups you have as anything else. So I think their floor obviously now is like, yeah, you could be at risk to get bounced in those first two rounds. Because let's be real, when Louisville was hosting, you know, regionals, nobody thought Louisville was losing in the first two rounds. Nobody did. And for, you know, for good reason. They're a great team. They have the home court advantage, all that stuff. But now you're taking that out. The team is still good. It's not as good as it was last year. So, yeah, do you want to be on a quote-unquote upset alert in those first two rounds? Yeah, sure. So I struggle with, like, the ceiling of, like, I'm just working off of what I've watched this year. And I think they can be a team that goes to a Sweet 16 Elite Eight. With how, from what I've seen so far, I think they have to establish another level of consistency this month to break through to another Final Four. Like, they have the talent. Talent's there. They have a coach with as good of a pedigree as any in the country. Just doesn't have a national title, which, breaking news, it's really damn hard to win a national championship. Extremely hard.
We don't have a national title because the refs took it away from it. I mean, 2018 against, you know,
I do laugh at people who like want to hold that against Jeff. I'm like, guys, like, I get it, he hasn't gotten that, but like, it's just extremely difficult win a national championship. I think the ceiling of, like, being realistic out of what we've seen from the body of work, like, I'm not going to be surprised if they go to, you know, they make it out of the first weekend, go to a Sweet 16, Elite Eight. I'll be a little surprised if they break through the Final Four, because I think they have to show a little bit more consistency than what they have this year. And it's funny to say that, because last year's team got eliminated early by Miami in the ACC tournament and then showed you how little that mattered with the run they went on. This year's team makes it to the ACC championship game. And is that the spark you needed to see to go on this run that, to get back to the Final Four? That's the ultimate question. So I don't know if that was a roundabout way of trying to get to your original question, but I think that's where I stand. If I had to put a final answer on it, like, my expected ceiling for them would be like, I think they can go to a Sweet 16 Elite Eight again. The floor, they can get bounced in the first round, because if the bad version of them shows up, then yeah, it's not going to be good.
Well, everybody can catch you with Chrissy and a Lexus on Sundays. Are y'all going to keep doing the rap this season?
We're trying, man. We didn't do one this past week because Alexis obviously was in Greensboro, and, you know, for the sake of total transparency, like, you know, Sundays can be, you know, if there's other stuff going on in the area that I have to go cover, like right now we obviously have high school basketball with the Sweet 16 coming up and regional finals, and, you know, this past Sunday was a great example of, like, I didn't have time to record the rap for the men or the women, honestly. I wish we did, but we just didn't have time. So if we can do it, we will. It's been fun to do this season, and I wanted to make sure that, you know, we have, I like the fact that we have a full women's segment to break down the team, because obviously it's one of the elite programs in the country, and people care about it a lot here. So, you know, we're going to try to keep doing it when it's, if it's possible. I know it's difficult when we have travel schedules and all that. So, but if even if it's not the rap, you know, just watch WHAS or follow me at Tyler_Greever on Twitter. I tweet too much, but I guess it's better than too little in this job. But yeah, I think it's a fascinating team to watch, the Smarts. They've the good Louisville, plenty capable of breaking through and making a deep run. The bad Louisville, fully capable of getting bounced in the first weekend.
Well, let's look ahead for a second. Okay. So we lose Narika, Mikasa, Liz, Josie, CeCe, and Morgan. We don't have any 2023 recruits coming in next year. I mean, is it a little worrisome that maybe Jeff Walz can't replace all that in the transfer portal?
I think you have to, like, take it into account, sure. You know, and you have to assume, like, in this day and age, that even the players you have, quote-unquote, coming back are actually coming back, because the portal goes both ways. Like, you have to be ready for anything in that scenario. I don't know. I wouldn't necessarily worry, I guess, about anybody leaving, like, to transfer elsewhere, unless I'm, you know, maybe I'm not privy to all the information there, but we'll see. I'm not really shocked by anything anymore in college sports. But yeah, he's going to have to hit it hard. There's no question about that. He's going to have to hit the portal hard. What's worked in his favor is that I think as a whole, he's shown that it's not a bad place to come if you're a transfer, especially if you're someone in another program who feels like they're a really good player and wants to go to the next level, not even just go to the next level, but come play at a place that appreciates the game and turns out for the program. I thought it was telling the back before senior day when CC, Josie, and Morgan was like, look, the Yum Center is awesome. Like, we love playing in front of the amount of fans that we get on a typical night. So that's big, but yeah, I definitely understand the concern there. Like, recruiting is recruiting. And nowadays, the game's changed. And obviously, NIL is a huge part of it. And you've seen some efforts to raise more money for the women's program to have a bigger pool of money to work with. But yeah, he's got to hit the portal hard. And then you have, you know, Marissa's got to take another step forward next year. But she, you know, she's turned into a nice player for them this season. Olivia, you know, will be a senior. And I think she's had a solid year, but I still think she has more in her as opposed to really taking maybe not a star turn, but like to up the production some. Obviously, Haley's back and you know what she's bringing to the table. But, you know, Nyla, do you take – how big of a step do you take as a sophomore? Because she will be relied on heavily. Zianna Walker was a big recruit coming out of high school. How much can she give you? Because we have not really seen her this year. There's a whole class of them. That's, you know, even Alexa Mobley, who, you know, had some injury issues and such, but now healthy and has seen like some sparing time here and there. There's some young pieces already on the team. Like, they have a lot of freshmen like ready to, who are going to have to step up next year as sophomores.
Well, Tyler, I appreciate you coming back on Off the Walz with me and breaking down the season. It's always good to have you on, and I appreciate the time, man.
Of course, man. I appreciate you having me on. Thanks.
Hey, what's up, Card Nation? Well, that was season two, episode 21 of the Off the Walz podcast. Once again, I'm your host, Brian Trent. The Off the Walz podcast is presented by the state of Louisville and brought to you by the Granville Pub at 1601 South 3rd Street. I want to thank Tyler Greever for joining me and giving a little season and ACC tournament recap and a little look forward at the NCAA tournament. Once again, if you all haven't heard, if you all have seen the shoes Jeff Walz has made, and I also have a pair of my own, they're made by my guy, Adam Wells, swagon12.com, or visit him on Instagram at swagon12 and 502. Go to his custom shoe page. You can buy a pair of custom shoes he already has on there, or you can get your own custom shoes made if you want. At checkout, enter the coupon code OFFTHEWALZ, all one word, and it'll get you $50 off a custom pair of shoes. That's it for this episode. So until next time, go Cards.